Hey guys, how's it going? It is Lady Survival here. I wanted to make a video today that's going to be a tattoo update because I've gotten quite a bit of work done since my last video a few months ago, so I'm going to update you guys on everything that I've gotten since then, and then I'm also going to be talking about upcoming work because I do have an upcoming appointment, and I have basically been booking appointments consistently, like just every single month to 2 months, depending on how soon I can get in. This video is going to be mostly about my Sylvanas arm thing because my whole arm is dedicated to Sylvanas Windrunner. For those of you who do not know, I am in love with Sylvanas. She's on my pillowcase. I have a whole like shrine thing back here for Sylvanas. My whole room is Sylvanas. I have been obsessed with and in love and adored everything about Sylvanas and her story and all that kind of stuff for the last like 8 years or something. Kind of gotten to a point where I like live and breathe Sylvanas. In my last video for my arm, I only had, as far as I remember, the dagger in front here and my Sylvanas piece, and since then I have gotten a lot more stuff filled in and done on my arm because this is going to be a full sleeve. We are very, very close to being done. My next appointment is August 27th and that should complete the sleeve. So I'm going to kind of stand up and show you guys the stuff that we have worked on. So I never really know where to begin. So this is kind of the newest big piece that I've gotten here. This is a crow that was done up in purple and it is holding Lady Sylvanas's necklace and its beak thing, and it's also on a gravestone which says Children of the Grave. And the reason why it says that, for those of you who may or may not know, Sylvanas did a speech during Halloween a few years back in like Wrath of the Lich King, and it was for the Wickerman's Festival, and she starts off her speech by saying Children of the Grave, and then she does this long speech about the Forsaken, and I just really, really love it. And it was also, that quote was used in the video promoting the Sylvanas statue that I have here. When they were showing it on the Blizzard YouTube channel, they were like, Children of the Grave, heed my call. So that's why I got that in there. I thought that it was just kind of like a speech for the Forsaken. And I got that maybe like 3 or 4 months ago. It's been a while. I've had it, I think I pretty much got it like a couple weeks after I made my last tattoo video, and once I got this, it kind of inspired a lot of like the graveyard theme that I kind of have going on, and it was kind of the point that I realized, you know what, I want to make this a sleeve, because I had the dagger, the Sylvanas, I got this added on, and then I also have this quote here, and I was like, you know what, I want to start filling this in. So my tattoo artist was so, so good at like helping me figure out like what we would use to fill in, because most times like it's probably best when you get a sleeve to have it all like thought out from the beginning and like start with like the lines and then fill everything in, but we just kind of did like piece by piece and filled it in from there. So I went in for another appointment to start filling it in, and we started adding in like all of these gravestones and like plant life kind of stuff in between here. It's kind of hard to explain like when each thing happened because I've had like 2 or 3 appointments with filling in all this stuff, so basically all of this colored stuff and plant stuff and sunset background stuff was my last appointment, but the appointment before that we had just started adding in like gravestones and plants without color or shading or anything. It was just like pretty plain. I can try to insert a picture of what it looked like at that point. In my most recent appointment, we added in like all of the plant life here, colored it in. This guy still needs to be colored in. We added in more gravestones, shaded them. There's some more color here. There's like a path thing here that Sylvanas is standing on. Some more gravestones on the back of my arm, and then we added in this moon with kind of like a dark, we have to add more color here, but this is kind of like a dark sky, and then in behind her is like a sunset background kind of thing. And basically the reason why we did that is because we had a lot of like cool tones and like purples and like dark colors and everything, and we were kind of like, you know what, we need to like contrast this or something. And my tattoo artist also plays World of Warcraft, so it's really great because we like can get really cool ideas together. And she was like, what if we did like a Silver Moon City kind of inspired thing, like the Blood Elf starting zone, so like Eversong Forest, and I was like, oh my god, like sunset backgrounds. So that's why we decided to do those colors. And in behind here, this still needs to be colored, but we have a tower. It's kind of like the architecture that's in the Blood Elf starting zone, of course. This still needs to be colored in and everything, but it's really, really, really pretty, and I'm super excited about it. And it's really awesome how all of this has come together, because basically my whole arm is like a death theme, but it also like tells a story as well, because it's like Sylvanas is obviously dead now, but it's kind of like her past is like behind her, so that's why we have like the Silver Moon Tower behind her, because it's like she was originally a Ranger General of Silver Moon, so that's kind of like, yeah, like that's part of her story and everything, so that means a lot to me. And then also how the crow is holding her necklace and everything, that means a lot to me. And I put the crow or raven, really either one, because of the Forsaken Crest, which has that in it as well, and also just kind of goes along with the whole graveyard and like death theme going on here. So I don't know, like all the gravestones are kind of meant to be like her fallen victims, but then she can also like raise them from the dead as like her own army, the Forsaken. So like my whole arm is just a huge tribute to Sylvanas and the Forsaken, which I like just absolutely love so much. And over the years I've just grown to love Sylvanas and her race so much more as time has gone on, and with her being Warchief it just means so much to me. That is my arm. My next appointment on the 27th is going to be used to fill in the rest of the color, color this guy in, finish the background, and just kind of pull more of like this kind of green in to fill in like everything, because this is kind of like the earth down below and then the sky up here. And then also we have a little bit of spare room right here, so we're gonna do like the Blood Elf crest kind of floating in the sky also behind her as like a representation for her past. Another tattoo that I got, which I think I mentioned in like my Skin and Earth cosplay video that was done like a couple weeks back or whatever, I got this piece right here. This is from a comic book that is done by like literally my favorite singer songwriter in the whole entire universe, by Lights, who I've talked about quite a bit, which again, Skin on Earth and everything. I just brought this as like a reference. I have all of her comic books, but she just recently released this hardcover version, volume 1. So inside this, there are these symbols, and it is a moon, a soul, and a sun. And basically it's just a symbol that's in the comic book and is on N's character, and Lights also has the same tattoo, and I got it because, one, I really, really love that comic book. I've never read comic books until this one, because it's just never really been a thing, so it was like my first comic book I ever like read and got into, so it was just really awesome, and having it done by my favorite songwriter, who I've been following for like 12 years and have been in love with for 12 years, it just really meant a lot to me, and then it went along really well with my cosplay, and it's just really awesome to have the same tattoo as your idols. That's really the whole reason I have a lot of inspired tattoos from people that I look up to. This arm, I'm not planning to do like a full sleeve, because I feel like at this point, like, I've kind of filled it in with like too many like small like symbol and quote things that like at this point it's almost too late to like fill it in like this one, but I do plan to just get more like kind of black and white, like either more quotes and stuff or more symbols. Like I'd like to get the Alliance and Horde symbol somewhere and just kind of fill it in with just more stuff. And if I'd like to, I might do like a dots and stars background to kind of make it a sleeve, but I don't really know. This is just kind of my arm for like random whatever stuff that I like. Aside from that, yesterday, and this is really the reason why I decided to make this video, my tattoo artist messaged me and was like, hey, I had someone cancel their appointment, would you like to come in? So I was like, you know I do. So basically, I had to work yesterday, but I just asked my boss, I was like, hey, like, I know I work 10 to 6, but my tattoo artist has an appointment open from 12 to 3, can I just like leave for 3 hours? And he was like, yeah, sure, why not? And in that time, I went and got my knuckles all tattooed, which is kind of crazy. I've always wanted to get hand tattoos and everything. I just kind of pictured it being like further into the future when like I felt like I was more ready for it. But I was like, you know what? I want them anyways, so may as well just do it. And Dark Lady fit perfectly, so I figured, why not? I literally love Sylvanas so much, so yeah. And it's really awesome too, because I talked about this before as well, but the right side of my body is kind of my like dark side slash Sylvanas dead everything darkness, and this side is kind of like the light things, because my heart is on my left side, so it's kind of like elvish and like positivity and all that good stuff, if that makes any sense. So it's really cool that it works out that dark is on this side and Lady is on this side. And then Lady also means a lot to me because my YouTube channel name is Lady Survival and my Instagram is Lady Survival Wow. So everything about like Lady And obviously Lady was inspired by Lady Sylvanas. Like, I just love Sylvanas so much. It's actually ridiculous. So that is really, really sick. I got some finger tattoos. My boyfriend just got his done as well, and that was really why I was like, oh my god, I need to get them done. And I was so lucky that my tattoo artist had an opening. This only took an hour. In terms of pain, it was not too bad. My boyfriend was like, you're gonna die, you won't be able to handle it. And I was like, I got a high pain tolerance, so it was like a 3 out of 10 for pain. It went by really quick, so yeah. So my camera just ran out of room, but I cleared some space and we're good to continue the video. So basically in terms of like next tattoo ideas and like what I plan to follow up with after we're done my sleeve, which should be by August 27th when my next appointment is, in which case I should be starting on to my next tattoos in like September, and to move on to my legs. And the first tattoo that I plan to work on is going to be a spirit healer from World of Warcraft on my left thigh, pretty big on like the front, kind of taking up a really big thigh space. And then once that one's done, I'm going to move on to my right thigh and put a Valkyrie. So it's kind of like a like life and like death angel thing, because this basically, for those of you who don't play WoW, this is the best way to explain what a spirit healer and a Valkyrie are. But I will also insert pictures of those guys just so that you know what I'm going for. Aside from that, I have a bunch of like ideas, but not necessarily sure where I'm going to put them. I plan to get Lokhnahak on my arm, which is a spirit beast from World of Warcraft. It's like one of the most sought after beast mastery hunter pets, and I got him like a few years back, like 6 or 7 years back or something, and it was like really, really awesome. He's my favorite pet ever. I'm gonna get that as kind of like a tribute to hunters and my love for cats and World of Warcraft all in one. I also plan to get the Horde and Alliance symbol, which I think I mentioned, and then I also have so many Sylvanas quotes that I want to get. It's actually ridiculous. Like, I want to get Dark Lady watch over you, all will serve. I want to get the quote, what are we if not slaves to this torment, which I think I'm gonna get on like my ribcage or something, not 100% sure, but there's just so many Sylvanas quotes that I want. There's at least like 5 or 6 for sure that I'm gonna get somewhere on my body, because it's amazing. I am also gonna be eventually getting like a sternum piece, like underboob tattoo. I'm gonna get my tattoo artist to draw up like a Sylvanas armor piece inspired one, so with like kind of the swirls and stuff underneath and like the hanging down chains or whatever, so I'm really, really excited for that. Eventually, I'm also planning to probably get like a ray gun, like right here, which Lights has as well, and I'm probably gonna get the same one because it's like inspired from her Captain Lights comic book, which was released like so many years ago, and she has that ray gun right there and it looks really, really cool. So I'm probably gonna get something like that because that would be awesome. And yeah, I don't know, that's kind of like in general everything that I want. I also do plan to get little symbols down below on my fingers, like a little like coffin and a skeleton and like a potion bottle and like all that kind of spooky stuff to fill in like the bottom part, because why not. And I will also eventually get hand tattoos, probably on both hands, definitely on this one though. I'm not sure, I might get like a skull or like a dead moth thing, something dead, I don't really know. At some point I want to get a tattoo of Verisa and Illyria, which are Sylvanas's sisters, because why not? And I might even get like their necklaces tattooed on me, even though I already have Sylvanas's, but I might get like the three of them, like maybe down my back or something, like all kind of whatever, like a red, a green, and a blue one for all of them. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. I have a lot of ideas, and like I literally just plan to, every single time I finish one of my tattoo appointments, I just book the next one. So I'm literally going in every month or two, like I said, depending on when an opening is. And anytime my tattoo artist has a cancellation, I will go. I don't care. I spend so much money on tattoos. I love them so much. They make me feel so much more confident and happy with myself, and like I'm doing something that's just like so empowering for me. Anyways, this is my full tattoo video. I think I kind of covered everything that I would want to. If you guys have any questions about tattoos or anything related to that, or anything at all, I really don't care. I will answer your comments down below. So thank you all so much for checking out my channel, and make sure you follow me on Instagram and Snapchat and all that stuff I have down below. And I hope you all have a very, very wonderful day, and I will see you again very, very soon. Bye guys!